Woo!
See, the men are getting cold and the British are coming! Blow your stock up a
Thank you. You've just missed 40% of the show.
You know what my shirt is, huh?
And I really thought that there was a seal of I have a group of 21 chargers putting counties out into three piles. And Arthur, I'd like you to choose one of the three piles and I'll do something kind of amazing with salt.
Okay,
choose one of the three. Okay, Beverly, you choose one of the cards in there without letting me see what card it is. So
Wait.
And let Arthur in on your thought. I won't be You decided on it?
Okay.
Now, let's just bury it right down the middle of all of this, and I'm going to deal the cards out one more time. This time, Beverly, I want you to guess which pile the cards you were just thinking of might be at. Let's see how lucky you can get.
Isn't it a trick question?
It's not a trick question. Choose one from one of this. Okay, let's see if you're right. Is the card that you were thinking of in that set?
No.
It's not. Well, let me try another one over here. Is it perhaps in that? No? By process of elimination, then we guess it must be in here. Is it in there? Let's try one more time. See if you can do better this time. Well, let's see. Maybe I can do better. I'll deal them out one more time. And this time, I'm going to guess that perhaps it might be in this pile. Okay? Am I right?
Oh, yeah.
It is. Now, that's only the beginning. Now, here comes the fun part. I'm going to spell out this. This is the card you took. B-H-I-S. This-I-S. Is G-H-E-B-C-A-R-D. Card. Y-O-U-U-T-O-O-K. And what was the card that you took?
Seven of Hearts.
The Seven of Hearts? $5 million. That's great.
All right for you.
Now, the interesting part is if you ever have a pile of seven cups and you spell out that magic phrase, this is the card you took, it will always bring you to the middle card. Now, that, of course, is one thing to remember. Now I'm going to show you, by mathematics, how you can always be sure that you have this thought-of card, the middle card in a pile. When the card is thought of, when it's been dealt out into several piles like this as we did before, now, a chosen card, let's just for the sake of anything, say that this is the chosen card. It's the Ten of Diamonds. Now, each time that it is identified as being in a particular pack, it's put in the middle of the other two packs. The second time, I will deal this out. We'll look for our Ten of Diamonds after this has been dealt out. Now, is it here? No, it's not there. Is it here? No, it's not there. So as we know, it must be over here. Now notice this is put in the middle between the other two packs. This time, when I deal it out, it will be the middle card of one of the piles. I don't know which one. So why don't we check and see which one it is? Is it there? No, it's not. I guess it may be here. Wrong as a guess. You know it's here. Notice it's the middle card.
Yeah.
And now, when we do as we did before, spelling, as we did, this is the card you took. It will always come up to the middle card.
Okay.
This is T-H-E-D-D-A-R-D. Card. Y-O-U-U-T-O-O-K. So the Ten of Diamonds is our card, and people will say, my golly, that's amazing.
But actually,
that's mathematics.
But it's good.
You won't believe this, but we got a seal out here who wants an autograph.
I don't know.
Oh, it's very nice.
Mathman, your mission is to control these factors of 6. When you encounter a number, you will have a group of counting systems to make your decision. And beware the dangerous mixture to
all right,
you will refuse if you are wrong.
Woohoo!
Mathman.
That's Factor of 60.
Yeah!
Mathman.
Factors of 60.
Mathman.
quadrilateral.
More quadrilaterals.
Parallelogram.
Aha, rectangle.
Squares.
The story you are about to see is a bit, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
4:42 p.m. in Los Angeles. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. I was working the day watch out of Mathnet. My partner is George Franklin, the boss is Sal Dean. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. We were working on the problem with the action date. We decided to look at a scene from yesterday's show to refresh our memory. A series of robberies had been committed by, of all things, a man in a monkey suit. Or so we thought, until...
And where did the man in the monkey suit strike this time?
That wasn't a robbery.
Oh?
It was a zoo.
The zoo?
Where they keep the animals?
Uh-huh.
Grunt is missing.
Who?
The zoo's prize gorilla Grunt is missing from his cage.
Now that we know that he's a gorilla and not a monkey, George and I go to the park and spoke with Buck Clyde, curator of the World Famous LA Zoo.
Well, the last anybody saw of him was at his 10 o'clock meeting this morning. Then, about an hour ago, I came by and found his cage with the door open. Grunt was gone.
Could you tell us what Grunt is certified?
Absolutely. This is Grunt's feeding chart. 60% fruits and vegetables, 30% grains, 10% dairy products.
Is the lock on the cage door broken?
No, it wasn't.
Grunt doesn't have a key, does he?
Of course not. Besides, it was a combination lock. It was just unlocked. It was gone.
Has he ever pulled this stunt before?
No. Grunt's very docile. He likes to be left alone.
Do you have any idea where he would go once he was free?
Not really.
Does he have any relatives around here? You know, maybe at other zoos or in the valley?
Grunt's only real friend is a little girl.
Could you tell us her name?
Jane Rice Burroughs. She comes here and helps out after school. She and Grunt liked each other. Sometimes I think they almost understood each other.
We'd like to talk to her.
Oh, please let me talk to her first. I'll have to explain what happened. She'll be devastated.
I've fired the locations on this map, Mathnet. This is where the first robbery took place.
Where was the second?
The second is here, and the third is here.
What's this point toward the top, Debbie?
That's the zoo. Now, on this map, the scale says 1 inch represents 2 miles. The first robbery took place 3 inches away from the zoo.
3 inches represents 6 miles.
Right. Could a gorilla have traveled that far? Let's assume he left the zoo at 10 o'clock. The first robbery call came in at 3.
That's 5 hours. Buck Clyde said a gorilla could travel at 10 to 12 miles per hour, but he couldn't do that for very long.
Theoretically, Grunt could have gone a maximum of 50 or 60 miles in that amount of time, but he couldn't have run full speed for 5 or 6 hours.
But he could have gone to 6 miles, even if he didn't catch every light.
Now let's figure out where he might be. It's been an hour and a half since the last robbery, which is here. It's kind of working.
If Grunt was still capable of traveling a maximum of 12 miles an hour...
In an hour and a half, Grunt could have gone another 18 miles.
1 inch represents 2 miles on this map. So I'll set my compass at a 9-inch radius. Put the point of the compass at the site of the last robbery. Grunt could be anywhere within this circle.
Betty, put out an agency on that area. Get every police car you can on the lookout for Grunt.
I'll check the area for stores that carry fresh produce.
Good idea, and I'll answer the phone. Monday. Wonderful. Send her in.
Got someone?
Jane Rice Burroughs, the little girl from the zoo here. Let's talk to her. I'll check on those markets for you, George.
Thanks, Debbie.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, Jane. I'm Kate Monday. This is my partner, George Franklin.
Hello, Jane Rice Burroughs. Please sit down.
Thank you.
Where do you live?
In the valley.
Whereabouts?
Tarzana. I thought maybe I could help you find my friend.
Grunt is really your friend?
He sure is.
By the way, how did Grunt get his name?
Well, I don't know. One day I asked him what his name was, and he just
We can use your help, Jane. We've got to capture him before he gets into any more trouble.
You didn't do those things you're saying about him this Monday. Grunt wasn't like that.
We know how you feel about your friend, Jane, but I'm afraid he did rob those stores.
But he just couldn't. Grant is very shy. It took him almost a year before he could even look at me. He hides from people.
Doesn't sound like the actual shy gorilla to break out of his cage.
But he didn't break out. This lock was open.
So he worked out the combination.
Mr. Frankie, gorilla's hands don't work like ours. They can't get their thumbs and their index fingers to touch. He couldn't turn the dial on a combination lock.
He could have pressed his palm against it, but there are 36 numbers on the lock.
And he needs to turn it to the three correct numbers to open it.
Aren't there a lot of combinations?
We'll figure it out. There are 36 numbers. I send it to the lock to begin.
Then he has to turn the knob back to the right past the first number, and he has 36 choices again.
So we multiply 36 times 36.
1,296, Kate. But he has to turn it around again to get to the third number. So that's another 36 choices.
So we multiply again.
1,296 times 36 equals 46,656.
46,656 combinations.
It's very unlikely Grunt could have found the correct combination by accident.
But it is possible.
I think somebody's gorilla napkin, that's what I think.
All right, Jane, but assume for the moment that you did do those robberies. We're trying to figure out where he is now so that we can catch him before he hurts someone.
Or if he gets hurt.
Right. See this map?
Uh-huh.
We figure he's somewhere in this circle.
I can figure that out.
Gorillas can go about 12 miles an hour. He left this spot an hour and a half ago.
An hour and a half times 12 miles an hour is 18 miles.
But Grunt's an old gorilla. He's out of shape.
Did he smoke?
No, but he couldn't run 12 miles an hour. Not for more than a few minutes, anyway. That's a mile every 5 minutes.
If he was there, and I just know he wasn't, but if he was, I think he couldn't be more than about 4 miles. One inch represents 2 miles. A circumference of 2 inches.
I say he's got to be right in there somewhere. If he isn't, I've got clues.
Why are you so sure?
This. What's that, a doll?
Uh-huh, it's the Fay Wray doll, and I gave it to Grunt. He takes it with him everywhere. He was still in his cage when I went to the zoo after school.
I know how he feels, boy. I had a Winnie the Pooh bear when I was a kid, and I hated to part with it. Actually, it's still around somewhere. Martha hid it.
I used to tell Grunt bedtime stories and feed him pizza.
Grunt likes pizza?
Uh-huh, he loves it.
James, just how tall was Grunt?
He's about 1.8 meters.
A meter is a little more than a yard. 1.8 meters is about 2 yards, or 6 feet.
That fits the description. How much did he weigh?
180 kilograms, more or less.
A kilogram is about 2.2 pounds.
So we multiply 180 times 2.2 and we get 396 pounds.
So he's about as tall as I am, but he weighs more than twice as much. And we both like pizza.
Pizza was just a treat. Gorillas are vegetarians and they eat a lot.
Does he like bananas?
Uh-huh, love them.
That's what was missing from the first robbery.
Does he like spinach and tomatoes and carrots?
Uh-huh. Why? Is that what was missing from the second robbery?
Uh-huh.
Jane, I'm afraid it was your friend Grunt. Maybe he just got so excited when he got out of his cage that he, well, he just changed.
Yeah, he went bananas.
Mathnet Monday. Who? I see. What is your location, sir? Thank you, sir. We'll be right out. Excuse me.
What's that?
The location of the latest robbery.
Was it?
Uh-huh. He just knocked over Balboa's pizzeria.
What did he get?
All the money and 3 large pies to go.
To recapitulate, all of the odd numbers went on strike to protest. Not to fear, we shall get down to the bottom of this.
Here's your report on something you didn't take.
Oh?
He broke into a home in Bel Air and took all the jewelry, silver, and money that he left one thing. Season tickets for the Rams game.
100% of Square One TV is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. This program is made possible by grants from the National Science Foundation, the U.S. Department of Education, the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the Andrew W. Mellon Foundation, and the Carnegie Corporation of New York.
Corporate funding is provided by IBM. At IBM, we believe education is the key to the future. We are pleased to help support Square One TV as an innovative way to introduce young people to the exciting world of mathematics.
This is